Welcome to Armanimation. I'm Arman. This video is about tips and tricks in spine. Subscribe to not miss the next voting. You can find more official tips here. Devs also leave juicy tips in the spine user guide. You'll be surprised how useful they can be. I spent a few days to carefully read complete spine user guide. And now I feel like I've graduated Spine Academy. I will leave the links in the description. Anyway, let's move to our tips. If you want to delete a skin while keeping the attachments, select skin placeholders and delete them by clicking this button. In this pop-up window, check this option to keep the attachments. Now you can go and delete the skin. To reduce the clutter in the tree view, hide skin name from attachment's name by checking this option. Did you know that path constraints apply on the slot and not the path attachment? So, if you create different path, same animation will work differently according to the path attachment that is active. If you are rigging joints, such as elbows, knees, or shoulders, we suggest to avoid meshing and weighting if possible. It limits the rotation of the joint. At some point, it will deform, not in a good way. In this example, if we have bound the meshes for the knee joint, we would not be able to flip it. Maybe we need that in some animations. So, if you don't want to bind meshes, spend extra minutes in Photoshop to make the joint parts overlap in a round shape. And back in spine, adjust the pivot point while checking real-time the bending in preview view. I am holding Alt key while clicking to redraw the bone. When I find the working pivot point, I can then redraw the actual bone, giving its length and direction. Now let me show how we animate tails using Little 3D. Here are some examples. The takeaway from those examples should be to also animate, translate and scale timelines. Why not also the shearing timeline? You can see that most of them use also scale and translate timelines. It is also possible to do without scale timeline, as with this one. Anyway, let me know in the comments if you want a separate video animating similar tails. Here are the series of quick tips. To access slot draw order quickly, use filter to show only the slots. And now you can modify the order. Use find and replace to rename stuff quickly. And to add a text at the beginning of anything, enable regular expressions and use circumflex symbol. When you search, hit Ctrl Enter to select the result right away. Right click on Save icon to save as. And right click on Open icon to open native dialog. Yes, and also drag from Open icon to show recent projects. You can add colors to the names in Spine by using tags. Note that this only shows in the editor. Final name will be exported including tags. Let's quickly see what we have in 4.1 version. We have a new type of attachment. Check this open to convert an attachment from ordinary to sequence. Let's see it in action. I will convert already existing sequence to new one, one attachment of type sequence. Remove all attachment but one. Now mark it as sequence and set the range. The range will be added to the name of the attachment or to the path here, if it's specified. Finally, go to animate mode and key the sequence. That's it, one row instead of 28. It might not fully replace ordinary attachment, since sometimes animators can do really amazing stuff using just few frames, blending them, overlapping, deforming. So new sequence attachment type is more just replacement of common use cases. And for more advanced cases, we still can use the old one. We have a swap button in weights view that will basically swap the values of two selected bones. You can lock the weight value by clicking on colored square. That will freeze the value of the bone for that mesh. It will remain unchanged even if you hit smooth. And for those who get frustrated with the box select not appearing instantly, we have a new option that will revert things back as they were. Also note that you can change this option for the dope sheet and graph view individually. Let's see what tips I have for you when working with the dope sheet and graph view. You can separate the handles of a key holding Alt key, and you can reconnect them by clicking Alt again while dragging. When you have your animation and at some point you see that the motion is too strong or too weak, you can scale down the whole curve. Use Store to see where was the original curve, so you better understand how much to modify the new one. And you can always swap back the curve with the stored one by clicking this button. One hotkey I use all the time is Ctrl+Shift+L. It will create keys for every timeline that is visible. This way I can adjust the timing, cut animations, and add new sections in between, being sure that motion is preserved. There is another similar hotkey, Ctrl+Shift+J, that will do exactly the same except it will key setup pose. If you work with long timelines, try using current button. Spine will automatically scroll the timeline during the playback. If you have multiple curves, you may consider framing portion of them, so spine will zoom in and show a clear view. And make sure auto formatting is disabled. If not, any change will zoom out to all visible curves. Right click on the curve to isolate it. And apart from clicking on the dots here, try right clicking on them. It will toggle the timeline's visibility. If you have selected the key on a curve, hit Ctrl+A to select all the keys on that curve. Hit again to select all the visible curves. In general, spine is very smart, especially regarding to selecting. If you have selected a handle of any key, hitting Ctrl+A will select all handles of that curve. Hit it again and you will select all visible handles. And hitting Ctrl+A third time will finally select all visible curves, keys and handles at once. It works similarly in the viewport. Wherever you have selected, hitting Ctrl+A will select all of that type in the viewport. And if you want to go with the box select and keys are so dense that you can't make a starting point, instead you select a single key, hold Ctrl and then drag. Spine will prioritize box select over selecting the key. If you have enabled repeat, you will see that the curves being connected at the start and at the end. You can also work with the handles. And click this arrow to open more space if it's not enough for you. Looking for more tips? Go check this video. See you in the next one. Bye.